Hello, I'm Mr. Brown, your science teacher. I make videos for students of all ages, and today we are going to explore the science of sea turtles. Let's talk about turtles. So you've got sea turtles live in salt water. Terrapins, we call them turtles too, live in fresh water, and tortoises live on land. You don't want to throw a tortoise in the ocean. They'll just sink right to the bottom, right? So, but you can see here, these are a couple of the different species of freshwater turtles found in North America. Some of these are found in Wisconsin. These are a couple different species of tortoises found around the world. Again, they walk on land. Tortoises don't do so good in the water. They just sink right to the bottom. Now, with sea turtles, they also have several different species. You can identify them by the plates on the shell on their back. And so here we see a couple different species. You got the leatherback, and you've got the loggerhead, and a couple other ones. Now remember, sea turtles, like all turtles, are reptiles, and they have to breathe air. Here you see a sea turtle coming up for a breath. If they don't, they'll drown. Yeah. Sea turtles have this amazing migration where they go all the way from the Americas all the way over to Africa, across the ocean and back. Some scientists speculate that they've been doing this for so long, ever since Pangaea broke apart. That's a long time. As far as we can tell, sea turtles are ancient. They've been swimming around since 110 million years ago. That puts you back in the Cretaceous period. That was the time of the dinosaurs. So these guys are super ancient. Back then, there was a species known as Archelon, a giant extinct sea turtle 80 million years ago. Look at the size of this guy. Why did this guy get so big? You'd be big too if you had to swim in the Mesozoic oceans. Okay, back then there was literally sea monsters in the seas. These are all real creatures, aquatic marine reptiles that existed during that time. So if you were a turtle, you needed to be big with a shell and protect yourself from all of the craziness that was going on in the Mesozoic oceans. 65 million years ago, it all comes to an end. The dinosaurs and all these guys go extinct. They're done, except sea turtles. They made it through somehow. They're pretty crafty. Today, there's only four reptiles known to live in the ocean. Sea turtles are one of them. The Galapagos marine iguana is another. The saltwater crocodile and sea snakes. Here you can see the anatomy of a sea turtle. They are beautifully adapted to life in the ocean. They have flippers, they have an aerodynamic shell, and they are just beautifully adapted to the world's oceans. A lot of species like Florida, and they've been going to the beaches of Florida for millions of generations. You can see here a couple of the species that call Florida beaches their home. So in the sea turtle life cycle, there has to be a point where a female meets a male. They have to mate in order for the female to fertilize her eggs. Now, I found this one, which talks about the difference between a female and a male, and I'm still confused even after seeing this. So I don't know which one's a male, which one's a female, but I know that they have to meet. The male has to meet a female in order for them to mate and successfully have eggs, right? Oh, excuse me, pardon me. I'm sorry, Mr. and Mrs. Sea Turtle. I didn't mean to interrupt. I'm sorry, carry on. So all of these are females. Each and every one of them has successfully mated with a male, and these females are headed up to beach to lay their eggs, as they've been doing for over 100 million years, okay? Can we get some privacy here, please? Here we see a huge leatherback female getting ready to lay her eggs, and plop, 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 down come the eggs in this little hole she dug. Let's let those eggs incubate for a few weeks, and we have hatchlings. Look at those beautiful little hatchlings. They are cute, yes. However, it's not a time to dilly-dally around. Instinct tells them they need to head to the ocean immediately. Like, no fooling around, run as fast as you can towards the ocean. Because just like in the Mesozoic, there's danger, there's predators. Today, you can see there's birds and crabs and sharks, and there's dangers all over the place. You need to get to the ocean as fast as you can. This little guy didn't make it. He got captured. But that's why they all run at the same time, because hopefully the turtles know some of them will make it to the ocean. Now, lately, some of these turtles, after they hatch, they get confused and they go the wrong way and they head into town. Maybe they think these lights are stars above the ocean, and some of these hatchlings are found just wandering around the streets of these local seaside towns, go back in the ocean. What these guys are doing is illegal. All right, you can't steal eggs. That's a federal crime. And I hope you go to jail. Now, these are some humans that are doing good. What they've done is they've created these little avenues to the ocean to help these little turtles find the ocean and protect them from predators. This is good conservation work. Nice job, humans. The sea turtles have coexisted with each other for so long that they've worked out a relationship. Different species will go after different foods. Hey, look, we'll go after crustaceans, you guys go after mollusks, you go after sponges, you go after plants, I'll go after echinoderms, you go after jellyfish, and it's just a beautiful system that they've worked out. Again, this is what happens when you coexist for 100 million years. You really get this stuff worked out. So here we see a leatherback going after one of its favorite foods, a jellyfish. The problem is, lately, the oceans are filled with plastic bags, and these poor sea turtles will be eating plastic bags that look like jellyfish. And so they've opened up some sea turtles that have died, and there's all sorts of garbage and plastic and junk found in their intestines. This guy's got fish hooks caught in his throat, and so they've really been hit hard by pollution. Here's another famous species, the Caretta caretta. That's the scientific name for the loggerhead sea turtle. This guy makes an appearance in the movie Finding Nemo. And here it is in real life, showing you in comparison to a diver. It's pretty big. These guys are facing multiple dangers. It's tough to be a sea turtle. This guy here got hit by a boat propeller and shattered its shell. But we have some really good veterinarians that have gotten crafty and wired this guy's shell back together. This guy is going to be okay. All right, so don't cry. Oh, he's not crying. That's actually a salt secretion gland, another adaptation to living in the ocean. All right. It's a tough life. This guy got one of his flippers bitten off in a shark attack. We're going to help you, little guy. We are going to do some 3D printing and make you a little prosthetic flipper. Look at that. You're going to be okay, little guy. Fishing nets are a big problem. Look at these sea turtles will sometimes get caught in these fishing nets. And what they've done is they've done this little device here. It's called the turtle excluder device, which allows turtles to escape fishing nets. All right, I like that. That's good thinking. Turtles are pretty adaptable, and they are found all over the world, except the cold waters of the Antarctic and the Arctic. How do we know this? Well, we put transmitters on their shell. All right, in the name of science, we will monitor where these turtles go so we can keep track of them. And they'll bounce their signal up to orbiting satellites and we'll process the data. And it's all really cool science. For example, here's a turtle that was tracked going along the beaches of Florida, then it popped over to Cuba, then it went back over to Florida for a while. And here's another tracking of a sea turtle that went out to the Bahamas for a little while. That's the life of a sea turtle. But how do they know how to navigate the oceans? This is a tough question. And What scientists think is the turtles can actually visualize the Earth's invisible magnetic field. Wow, that would be pretty cool. And they've actually tested it by putting these turtles in a tank, and they're able to point themselves in the right direction, and pretty amazing stuff. Thank you for joining me today. We talked about the science of sea turtles. I am Mr. Brown, your science teacher. I'll see you next time. Bye.